I believe in the old adage, tell me and I forget, show me and I remember, involve me and I understand. But I'd like to take this a step further by adding, challenge me, engage me, and I'll learn. Even though I've taught thousands of students at a variety of institutions, I hesitate to call myself a professor, a teacher, or instructor. I'd rather be called a learning facilitator. This really is not a matter of semantics, but it is fundamental to understand the significance of constructivism, active learning, inquiry-based learning, and learner-centered education as a whole. Teaching, or to teach, is to impart knowledge or skill to someone by instruction or example, or to give lessons in a subject. In contrast, learning, or to learn, is coming to know something, to acquire knowledge, or to find something out. Therefore, a teacher is a person who imparts knowledge, skills, information, while learning facilitator is one who creates an environment in which someone can come to know something, acquire knowledge, or gain information and experience. The significance in these definitions and the realization of what happens when we teach as opposed to facilitate learning is that a teacher, by definition, is focused on themselves and their ability to impart knowledge or information. The saying, sage on the stage, is extremely appropriate in this context. In contrast, a learning facilitator is focused on the learner and on creating a desirable learning environment in which a learner can come to know and acquire knowledge and make meaningful connections. They're a guide on the side. Now, learning is an active and dynamic process in which learners construct new ideas or concepts based on their current and past knowledge. The making of meaningful connections is key to learning and knowing. We need to move from passive educational environments of main lecture points, rubrics, individual competition, standardized testing, to an active educational environment of interactive, engaging learning and presentations, critical and analytical thinking, collaboration, meaningful, authentic, real-world projects. When you combine these fundamentals with a purposeful design to building a holistic student-centered environment, we can create significant learning environments that will help our learners learn how to learn and grow into the people we hope they will all become. This really isn't a new concept or idea. We design information systems, smart buildings, ecological friendly communities, and so many aspects of society, but we unfortunately do not apply this holistic approach to designing our learning environments. Now, whether we're purposeful in its design or we just allow circumstances to dictate its development, schools, colleges, universities, our classrooms, we're providing learning environments for our students. Now, rather than allow those environments to come together willy-nilly or inadvertently and respond reactively to the learning dynamics that arise, I encourage us as educators to become proactive and create significant learning environments that inspire, foster, and facilitate deeper learning. Now, this is what I believe about teaching and learning and significant learning environments. This is my learning philosophy. In this course and module, you'll have the opportunity to clarify and codify what you believe. Your beliefs about learning need to guide your actions in creating significant learning environments. Now, I'll caution you that in developing and maintaining a learning philosophy, it's an ongoing process. And even if you've considered this earlier at some other point, you will more than likely see that you'll need to edit and continue to update your thoughts. Through these videos, this course, on my blog, my e-portfolio, you'll clearly see what I believe about learning. What do you believe? What is your philosophy? What is your learning philosophy? You'll have the opportunity to really develop these.